a moment, covered in dust and blood, I found myself in a moment of existential crisis. I was looking down at who I was, and that person had completely been transformed by a vehicle accident. You know, I saw a leg that was something I depended on my whole life that had completely changed. All that stuff I had built up towards in the years leading up to the accident was thrown out the window, right? It was like, who am I now? I think a lot of amputees face that moment. You know, they have faced that crisis moment. I think that's what Össur is about. It's about trying to provide a completely new set of narratives that you can choose from when you face that moment of crisis. I don't remember a lot from the day of the accident, but I do remember being wheeled into the hospital, and the first thing I asked the doctor was, do you think I'll ever surf again? When Brent showed up at my hospital bed and showed me this picture of this guy, not only surfing, but deep within this tunnel of water, this barrel, with his prosthetic foot sticking out the back, everything changed inside me. I was literally a week out of the hospital, and I go to a CAF event, right in front of the Össur booth, actually. And I meet Mike Kutz and my other friend, Andre Zooks. And I found this picture recently of us together. They're standing there with their grins on their face, and I'm sort of holding on to them for support with my wheelchair in the background. And I just think back to that moment now and think, wow, what a journey it's been this last 5 years. One of the best parts of being part of the Össur family is reimagining who you are is not like a thing about limits, but rather a thing about limitlessness. And I remember National Geographic being absolutely 100% supportive, but just letting me choose my limits. I get a call maybe 6 months after I get out of the hospital saying, look, all that stuff you're doing in Guatemala, they just got a big commission to do a huge laser mapping survey across the jungle. We've got a helicopter on standby. Are you ready to go? And I grab my leg, ProFlex, and I strap my backpack on with my number 4 Allen wrench, and I head off to the jungle, with a machete in hand. That first expedition, it started this new journey of being a bionic explorer, right? And since then, I've traveled all around the world in search of what it means to be human, what our human story is. I get messages probably once a day now from, and I wasn't expecting this, but from people that might be in the very exact same moment that I was in 5 years ago, right? Lying in a hospital bed, staring up at a TV, wondering what their life's gonna be like, and then all of a sudden seeing me come across the screen. And if that can do something for somebody, if that can give somebody a version of what they might be able to see themselves as in the future, then I feel incredibly fulfilled knowing that that's out there, right? Just paying it forward. Every morning before I put my leg on, I hop to the bathroom. I barely make it. You know, I'm literally on one leg. And then I put this piece of hardware onto my body, and the next thing you know, I could be climbing a mountain. I could be skiing down the side of a double black diamond. I could be scuba diving. I could be surfing a 20-foot wave. But you think it's a piece of hardware, but it's not just a piece of hardware. It's hope, it's empowerment, it's a life.